Good morning, and welcome to our celebration of the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Mass is being offered for Nadine O'Connell. Our opening song is Holy, Holy, Holy. Please stand.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Today in the second reading, St. Paul advises us, have the attitude as of Christ. As Christ was obedient to Father's will, today's readings invite us to be obedient to the commandments of Jesus. And today as we are here to listen to God's word and to receive his Eucharist, let's ask Jesus to help us to live the commandments. And now we shall begin our Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let's ask God to forgive our sins and make us worthy to celebrate this Eucharist.
Let us pray. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned
in my thoughts, in my words,
in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of the clear. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of the clear.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises haste to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say, the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel, is it my way that is unfair, or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns from the wickedness he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life. Since he has turned away from all the sins that he has committed, he shall surely live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord.
Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember your compassion, O Lord, and your merciful love, for they are from of old. Do not remember the sins of my youth, nor my transgressions. In your merciful love, remember me, because of your goodness, O Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. He shows the way to sinners. He guides the humble in right judgment. To the humble he teaches his way. Remember your mercies, O Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, with the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interests, but also for those of others. Have in you the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. of God. Harden not your hearts. Listen and receive the joy of the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not,' but afterwards changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet, even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Today, the parable in the gospel reading is quite simple. A father had two sons. He goes to the first one, "Can you go to my vineyard and work?" He said, "No." Later, he changed his mind and went and worked. The second one said, "Certainly, immediately I'll go." But he didn't. To understand this parable, it's very important to know the context. Today's gospel reading is from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 21. The last few days of Jesus' life here on earth. He goes to Jerusalem for the feast. There were hundreds and thousands of people gathering. And as Jesus went, he saw the temple as a marketplace. People selling things, buying, exchanging money. It was like a market. And Jesus becomes so angry, he turns the tables upside down, takes a whip and drives them out. Of course, this upset the Pharisees, the teachers, and the scribes. And they asked Jesus, "Who gave you the authority to do this? Who gave you the power to do this?" And in this argument between the priest and Jesus, Jesus speaks three parables. All three parables are named as rejection parables, the parables of rejection. And today's parable is the first one. We will hear one next week and the other week after that. 3 weeks, three rejection parables. The context is, Jesus is telling, "You said yes to the will of God. God called Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and all of you children of Israel. You said yes, but John the Baptist came, you did not accept him. When I came, you wanted to kill me. But look at the tax collectors, sinners. They didn't say yes in the beginning, but now they are accepting John the Baptist. they are willing to accept me. You have said yes, but not did it in your life. Very important point here, brothers and sisters. They have been believers of Yahweh for centuries. They said yes, they received 10 commandments. They received the law, but they did not practice it. Today, every parable speaks to the people who heard that time. It also speaks to us today as we hear from the pulpit. Are we like the first son who said no and later changed his mind and did the will of the Father? Are we like the second one? We said, yes, Jesus, but we don't care about his word practicing in our life. Have we said yes or no? I'm sure all of us, believers, Catholics, and Christians, we all said yes in our baptism. Do you remember your baptismal vows? The priest would ask, do you reject Satan? What do we say?
I do.
I do. Do you reject all his works?
I do.
I do. Do you reject all his empty promises?
I do.
Do we keep up to that? Like the son, yes, I'll go and work in the vineyard, but didn't care about going there. We said, I reject Satan, I reject all his works and all his empty promises, but now we do the same thing. Today's reading is inviting us, dear brothers and sisters, it is not enough to say yes, but we have to do it. It's important to say yes too. We should know the will of God, and much more than that, doing the will of God is very important. In Matthew's gospel, we see Jesus telling us, not everyone who says, Lord, Lord, will enter into the kingdom of heaven. Not everyone who says, but only the one who does the will of my Father. Sometime back, a man went to the priest and said, Father, I have a dream in my life, and I wanted to fulfill that before I die. And the priest asked, what is the dream? He said, I want to go to Holy Land, climb Mount Sinai. Have you been to Mount Sinai? Yeah, it's quite tall. I have been there too. I want to go to Holy Land, climb Mount Sinai, and I wanted to read aloud the Ten Commandments. And the priest said, that's wonderful, my son. Why don't you stay here and practice them? No, it's good. There's nothing wrong in going to Holy Land. I have been there. There's nothing wrong in climbing Mount Sinai. It's wonderful to know by memory all the Ten Commandments. But what's the use if you're not practicing them? Know the will of God and do the will of God. Matthew, in Matthew's gospel, at the end of Sermon on Mount, Jesus looks at all the people and says, blessed are you who listen to my teaching, act accordingly. Knowing the will of God is only the first part of it, but doing the will of God is the most important thing. And when should we do it? We should do it every day, today. Let's not postpone it. Oftentimes I hear people telling me, from next Lent, I will start coming to church every day, Father. From next January 1st, New Year, I make new commitments. I do this and I do that and I'll practice this. Do it now. There's a Danish philosopher called Soren Kierkegaard. He's a Christian philosopher and theologian. He often quotes a parable. Tomorrow I will fly to south. Have you heard that? Tomorrow I will fly to south. He's talking about a group of geese, maybe 10, 15 of them. We see geese flying in bunch and groups. These geese decided, winter is coming very soon. We have to fly to south to escape the winter, the cold. And they all decided a day. They started to fly. After a day's journey, they looked down and they saw cornfield, tasty and wonderful corn. All the geese came down, had their fill. And they wanted to start back their journey, fly to south, or you'll get caught in winter. Except one. One said, "You go ahead. This corn is wonderful, tasty, and plenty. Let me enjoy for one more day, and I will fly tomorrow." Tomorrow came. The same attitude. The corn is sweet, tasty, and plenty. Let me stay for one more day, and tomorrow I will fly to south. It went on and on. And lo and behold, the cold winter air started to blow. And he said, "This is the time I have to fly. And if I don't fly now, I might die in this cold." And picked up all the energy, started to fly south. What happened? After a few minutes, he started to come down. Come down and down and fell to the ground. And realized in these few weeks, he was so pleasurably enjoying the corn, became too fat and could not fly anymore. Oh, true, dear brothers and sisters, we postpone good things for tomorrow. Tomorrow may never come. It may be too late. You may be too tired, maybe too old sometimes. Three important points. Know the will of God, do the will of God, and do it now. Do it now, today. Let's not postpone it. Because Jesus very clearly said, "Only those who do the will of my Father will inherit heaven." Not who know the will of the Father. Not the one who postpones the will of the Father for tomorrow. The one who knows, the one who does, and one who does it today. Let's ask Jesus to help us to know his will, to do his will now and today. We shall all stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, light from light, true God from true God. Proceeds from the Father and the Son.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, trusting in God, our loving Father, we shall ask for our needs.
Our response today will be, "Give ear to us, O Lord." That our Holy Father Francis, Archbishop Paul, and all the clergy of the Church will show us by their words and actions how to respond to the call of Christ, we pray, "Give ear to us, O Lord." As a community of faith, may we always support life from conception to natural death. We pray. Give ear to us, O Lord. As a community of faith, may we be honest and sincere in responding to the will of God with unwavering obedience. We pray. Give ear to us, O Lord. May we comfort the sick and brokenhearted, and may they experience the love and compassion of Christ in those who take care of their needs. We pray. Give ear to us, O Lord. May we open our hearts as people of generous faith in supporting the victims of fires, hurricanes, flooding, and the many good works of Catholic charities. We pray. Give ear to us, O Lord. And for those who have died, we pray especially for Joan Gibson, mother of Martha Gilliland, and for Tim Reardon, cousin of Mary Jo Fisher. May they experience everlasting joy in heaven, we pray. Give ear to us, O Lord. And for those prayers offered before the Blessed Sacrament in adoration and our personal petitions, we pray. Give ear to us, O Lord.
Let us pray. Loving Father, accept all our prayers and petitions and continue to bless us in a very special way to know your will and do it by your grace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
For the praise and glory of his name.
For our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessings may be laid open before us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather your people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, your pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercessions in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let's pray for the coming of God's kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. I'm not worthy. A reminder, all those who want to receive the body of Christ on their tongue, please come only to the priest or to the deacon. All those who want to receive the Eucharist in the tongue, Please come to the priest or deacon to receive it.
Jesus. Defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of devil. We have a couple of announcements. This weekend is Disaster Relief Weekend. There are envelopes at the hospitality desks and assure stations. Please take one to contribute for this cause. And this collection is for those suffering from storms along the Gulf Coast and the fires out west. And the second, the Feast of St. Francis of Assisi is next Sunday, October 4th. We will be having pet blessing on playground, school playground at 2 p.m. Please bring your pets if you need to be blessed. Now we shall all stand for the final blessing. Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be coherent in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace.